Hi there, my friends. This is Michael Vincent. I just wanted to take a few moments to say hi to you all. I hope you've all been well over the last few days. I've taken a few days out just to think, relax, meditate. Life is certainly different now. The government is issuing severe warnings of going into shops wearing face masks and so forth, and it's just a reflection of the way things are, trying to maintain a perfect balance of healthy bodies, healthy state of mind. So I guess we all have to abide by these new rules and conditions. I'm here to say, don't let it get you down. Keep a positive mindset. This lockdown is an opportunity to create something new. What will that new be for you specifically? I know for myself, if there's one thing I'm present to right now, is how quickly time disappears. Time is becoming much more distorted for me because my days are a lot fuller now than ever before, in spite of the lockdown. I wake up in the morning, I get myself ready, I go for my morning ritual, my coffee shop is open, I drink my cappuccino, I shuffle my cards, I practice, I experiment with different ideas. This is my morning ritual, and I'm very happy that I can do that now because it was a big missing for me since the start of the year. Now, exciting news to share with you. I've decided to release a new book, two new books, in fact, with two more on the back burner. This new book will be entitled Lockdown Meditations. Exactly that. How I'm using time now to meditate, create, visualize, and it's magic related, obviously, and there's a new routine I'm going to be sharing with all of you, which I'm very excited about. I won't tell you what it is just yet because it's too abstract. It's better that you see the video because it's very exciting. Yes. And I hope once this book arrives in your hands, you can certainly see how I've used time to look at my magic and reframe a few things. And when I say reframe, I'm really talking about what's the new context for me, Michael Vincent, because I'm not in front of an audience. I'm speaking to a camera. The one thing I will not engage in is virtual performances. I don't believe in that. I was trained to stand in front of live breathing human beings and to get into their minds, to relate to them as human beings, and then to present my magic inside a context where people feel safe, they trust me, I trust them, and entertain them, and then blow them away with beautiful magic. To me, there is nothing more beautiful than that. And I cannot generate that same kind of excitement, energy, emotion, and passion staring into a camera. I need to look you straight in the eye. I need you to look into my eyes. And I need you to be hooked on every word that's coming out of my mouth. And to me, there is no process more beautiful than that. It really is something special. And I think it's worth fighting for. I'd like you to stop and think. What does magic mean to you? What does your performance mean to you? What does it mean to you to be in front of human beings sharing your magic? Is it about your ego? Or do you have something of profound value that you want to impart and share? Being a magician is the most extraordinary privilege of my entire life. Why? I know that magic is so powerful, it can give an audience an experience they cannot get any other way. That rare thrill of a pure astonishment. Oh, it's been a long time since I've had it. But I know what it feels like, and it's a gift I can give away to someone. That's why I practice. This is why I will go to extraordinary lengths to create a miracle. Why? Because I have a vision in mind. This new routine I'm working on started off purely as a simple question. What if? Would it be possible? Can I achieve this? Do I have the tools in my toolbox to create this vision? As it happens, I did. And with very little adjustment, I took some existing ideas, collapsed them together to create a brand new expression of something you're all familiar with. So stay with me on this one because I think you're going to love it. Lockdown meditations. So I would like to throw out a challenge to you. No matter what you're thinking or feeling during this lockdown, it's a golden opportunity to stop. Breathe. Be still. Empty your mind. Thoughts will come and go. Let them. Have you noticed if you leave muddy water alone, it will clear all by itself? That's the natural law of things. So if we just allow ourselves a few minutes every day to be silent, be still. In fact, I recommend that you read a book by a Norwegian explorer named Erlend Kage. The book is called Silence. Now, this comes really easy to me now. Watch this. The minute I take off my hearing aids, I cannot hear a thing. And being in a world of silence, oh my God, I have come to appreciate the beauty of nothingness, silence, no sound. You see, it took me a while to come to terms with being deaf. Right now, I can't hear anything. All I can hear is a slight humming. I have tinnitus, and on some days it can be very aggressive, drives me mad. Right now, it's relatively calm. That moment of silence is beautiful. I challenge all of you to become comfortable with it. Sit in a chair, set your iPhone for 5 minutes, and do nothing except breathe. Just breathe. The code of Bushido, life in every breath. Life in every breath. We're alive. We are alive, my friends. And in spite of the current situation, we use our life to love, create, and make a difference somewhere. I'm not going to perform any magic today. In fact, I think this video has been pure magic, simply because in spite of what I'm dealing with, I can still share and express myself. And for that, I am profoundly grateful to the gods that may be. So today, my friends, just stop, breathe, and say thank you to whatever God means to you, whatever the universe means to you, okay? Because we are a creation out of that energy, okay? Michael Vincent signing off. Have a good day. Check in with me tomorrow. I'll have a great piece of magic for you. Thank you.